Hello learners, our today's session is on new economic policy of India. In a previous session of economic reforms part one, we have discussed about the reasons of economic reforms and poor policies of India before 1991. In this session, we'll have discussions on how economic reform process has been initiated in India through the introduction of new economic policy in 1991. So we'll start with what is new economic policy. New economic policy refers to economic liberalization or relaxation in the import tariffs, deregulation of markets or opening the market for private and foreign players, and reduction of taxes to expand the economic wings of the country. So main motive of new economic policy was to open the closed economy of India for the global exposure. The new economic policy of India was launched on 24th July 1991 by Union Finance Minister Dr. Manmohan Singh and Prime Minister P.V. Narasimha Rao. Dr. Manmohan Singh is also known as father of economic reforms. Next is the branches of new economic policy. Learners, the economic reform process has been completed via three other processes, and they are liberalization, privatization, and globalization. And they are called LPG in short and popular form. So what first one is liberalization. What is liberalization? Liberalization refers to lessening of government regulations and restrictions for greater participation by private entity. So liberalization means to reduce the government role in the economy and promote and encourage the private players or private enterprises to enter in the market to run the business. In economic policy of 1991, the following steps were taken under liberalization measure. First is free determination of interest rate by commercial bank. Before 1991, it was the RBI who fixed the interest rate for the banks. But after 1991, commercial banks were given freedom to determine the interest rate or fix the interest rate on the basis of their perception of risk. Next is increase in the investment limit for the small scale industries, SSIs. The investment limit for small scale industries has been increased to 1 crore rupees so that they can upgrade their machinery and increase their efficiency. Next is freedom to import capital goods. In a liberalized era, the industries are free to import the capital goods like machinery, raw material from the foreign country for their holistic development. Next is freedom for expansion and production to industries. In a new liberalized era, the industries are now free to expand their business and reduce their cost of production. But earlier, before 1991, it was the government who fixed the capacity of the production, and no company can produce goods more than that limit, which was fixed by government. But after 1991, industries are free to increase their production or expand their production according to the demand of the products in the market. Abolition of restrictive trade practices. As per the MRTP Act 1969, the companies whose assets worth rupees 100 crore or more than 100 crores, they are known as MRTP firms, and they are under the government restriction. But after the abolition of MRTP Act, companies are free to increase their investment. Next is removal of industrial licensing and registration. Before 1991, private enterprises, private players, they have to take the license from the government to run the business. But after 1991, through de-licensing and de-registration, such approval of government is not required now for the private players. So this is all about the liberalization. Next is the privatization. So privatization means transfer of assets from public sector units or public sector undertakings to the private sectors. During the time period, there are different meaning of privatization has been developed. So these are the different types of privatization. First one is denationalization, and it is the purest form of privatization. In denationalization, government sell the 100% share of public sector undertaking to the private sector. Such kind of privatization has never been done in India till now. In some of the European countries like Italy, France, Spain, such kind of privatization, such route of privatization has been adopted in 1990s. But majority of the democratic nations never followed this kind of privatization's route. Next is disinvestment in public sector undertaking. This is the second type of privatization. In disinvestment, government sell less than 100% share of the public sector undertakings to the private sector. When government sell 49% shares of the public sector undertaking to the private sector, then the ownership is remain with the government, but this is the form of privatization. And when government sell 51% shares or more than 51% shares of the public sector undertakings to the private sector, then ownership is transferred to the private sector, and it is also the privatization. Government generally do disinvestment to raise funds, and they use such funds for the development of the country. Next is minimization of public sector. This is the third and last type of privatization. When the government made such policies which encourage and promote private enterprises to enter in the market and run their business with minimum restrictions. And in 1991 economic policy, through de-reservation and de-licensing, government encouraged such kind of privatization. The number of industries reserved for public sector has been reduced from 17 to 2, and that is railway industry and atomic and defense energy. Now only 2 industries are left for the public sector. Rest all the market is open for the private player. So this is the form of privatization. And next is the globalization. Globalization refers to the opening up the economy more towards foreign investment and global trade. So globalization can be defined as to integrate the domestic economy with the rest of the world so as to encourage the foreign investment and global trade. In new economic policy of 1991, following steps are taken for globalization. First is reduction in tariff. Custom duties and tariffs has been decreased in the export and import of goods to encourage foreign trade. Partial convertibility of Indian currency. Partial convertibility can be defined as to convert Indian currency up to specific extent into the currency of another countries, so that the flow of foreign investment in the form of foreign institutional investment and foreign direct investment has been increased. Before 1991, to convert the currency, RBI's permission was required. But after 1991, no such permission is required. Up to specific extent, people can convert the currency without any permission. Next is increase in equity limit of foreign investment. The equity limit of foreign capital investment has been increased from 40% to 100%. In 47 high priority industries FDI to the extent of 100% will be allowed without any restriction. So these are the steps taken for the globalization in the new economic policy. Learners, these three processes, liberalization, privatization, and globalization, they are connected. Liberalization shows the direction of the economic reform, that is more inclination towards the dominance of market. But how will it be achieved? So it is the privatization who shows the path or way through which the ultimate goal of globalization can be achieved. If India is, if today India is shining on the world map, it is only because of these reforms which have been initiated in 1991. Means whole credit goes to this new economic policy of 1991. The reforms are still going on in India, and these are the reasons of the economic development of the country. So this is all about today's session. Thank you.